Thanks for joining us. I'm Drew Lyon, and I'm here with Karl Russo. We're with the National Economics and Statistics Group of PwC. And today we're talking about some of the economic takeaways that we can observe from the Tax Reform Act that was passed in late 2017. So Karl, it's been nearly 2 years since enactment. I'm wondering what's most striking to you as you observe the economy.
Well, it does appear that the economy is growing faster than was predicted prior to the enactment of the legislation. One of the things that I find striking is it seems that it's being driven by a very large increase in the number of hours worked and a big labor supply response. And that's consistent with the reduction in the marginal rates on labor income that were a part of that act. It's also consistent with the data we're seeing on unemployment. So we have the lowest unemployment rate in 50 years, the lowest black unemployment rate since we've been keeping statistics, the lowest Hispanic unemployment rate as well. So those gains are pretty broadly shared. And it's somewhat surprising that we're seeing that on the consumer side. I wonder what you're seeing on the business side of things.
Yeah, on the business side, one thing we've seen is very significant financial flows, repatriation. Nearly $1 trillion has come back to the U.S. from overseas in the first 6 quarters since the tax reform bill was enacted. And I expect we'll continue to see those repatriations continue at a fairly healthy clip relative to before tax reform. And then in terms of the real economy, in 2018, we did have a rather significant increase in capital spending by companies, equipment structures, intellectual property, and that has slowed down for the most part in 2019, particularly equipment and structures. And I suspect that is largely due to the uncertainty we're seeing from trade policy. So we'll have to see what emerges in future quarters on that. Well, thank you, Karl, for joining us. And thank you for joining us. Please join us again next month.